Okay, good afternoon. Welcome back after lunch session. And now we have in this session 6 presentations, each 10 minutes duration, same thing. I request you cooperate with me, all the speakers, and maintain the same time, 10 minutes, okay? Now the first talk is by Dr. Trinath Pachal, Sail Bokaro.
Friends, today is World Health Day, and this year's theme is depression. Let's talk. And I don't have an intention to make you depressed after lunch. So, I want to share my concern in the small scale industries of India. The scenario which we always miss in our different research or academic activities or in production activities. Why small scale industry? And this is the backbone of our growth of our country, and more than 40% of the gross industrial values added to our Indian economy, more than 6,000 products we are selling in the market, both India and foreign market, and its contributions in GDP will increase. That's the predictions. But is it the scenario? Poor financial situations and low level of R&D, poor adaptability to change trends, and these all are with the lack of management, lack of assets, which we have discussed for the last 1.5 days. Friends, this is the extract from a high level professionals of our India. There is something missing in the list, and this is one of the important aspects they forgot, that productivity and cost benefit of small scale industry is highly associated with worker safety, health and well-being. Why? If anybody of you visited any small scale industry of India, you will rarely see that any safety appliances they are using. Forget about the PPEs. Even the safety boots, even the dress, mostly they are using the loose dress in their small scale industry. And no accident or near miss records. If you go and ask them, is there any accident? Immediately they will say, no, there is no accidents. And the government has no access to this huge accidents record and no near misses. And there is no occupational disease records in government of India's hand for this small scale industry. No routine health evaluation system. Forget about the health evaluation system. But the most dangerous is forced termination after any disease and disability. Look at that person. That person is a minor fracture in the ulnar region, the hand, due to an accident. And he needs 6 weeks plastering. When he returned after completion of his plaster, then he identified that his job is lost. Now what he is doing? He is doing one of the world's most laborious work in terms of physiology. Professor K. Kogi has said in the last IIT meeting that this is one of the highest physiological cost labor of the world. He is doing about 300 to 400 kgs of load he is carrying, just pushing in a single bicycle 40 to 60 kilometers in scorching sun or chilled cold in hilly terrain. So this is the ultimate. So, and there is no welfare scheme also for them, this SHL. And government has protection forces and protections system with the factory acts, adequate safety measures to promote health and welfare of the workers employed in factories with factory acts, employees provident fact, provident fund act, compensation act, employee sales insurance act, and so on and so forth. And the list is not completed. There are several other protections. And sir, my question, can this act protect these octogenarian people to work, to stop to work at the age of 84, 85? There is no system. There is no system. And you can't deny and you cannot resist this person. And the list is long, prolonged. I can go on giving the list. Can we protect this child labor for doing? Last 3 days back, I have just found one article that 2,000 cases pending in our court for this child labor. That's enough. Nothing beyond that. So we can't stop. If we see closely the scenario, the first is the garment industry from Gujarat, second is sawmills from Jharkhand, third is Bengal and Jharkhand bordering districts, brick factories, and the fourth one is interesting, this is from Andhra Pradesh. Sir, look at the diseases. The musculoskeletal disorders, it extend from 60 to 80%. Can you believe that one of the society to whom you are trying to make them uplifted, 80% of the population is going to be disabled in future days, in few coming days. So this is the scenario. Forget about the GI disorder, hypertension, and infective disorder, skin disorder, everything you forgot. Just the musculoskeletal disorders. What is the reason? The reason behind this may be the traditionally designed tools they are using, mostly manual operation or material handling job they are doing, long hours of working, no fixed scheduled time for 8 hours. It can be extended to 12 or 30 or 14 years, hours, and poor hygiene and ventilation in the workplace. In any small scale industry you visited, you see the poor hygienic conditions. Ventilation is very poor, whether it is a furnace or whether in a hot place or a hot job operation, there is a ventilation is very poor. And there is a mismatch between workers' ability and job demands, and diseased employee that work. And finally, sir, there is no concept of ergonomics. They can't think about ergonomics. So these are the few pictures: poor sitting arrangement for operators, repeated back bending job for the brick workers, prolonged awkward machining work, prolonged awkward, the same posture they are doing, and this is a prolonged back bending and load lifting, huge lifting in this factory. These are the ergonomics problem: prolonged sitting operation in match factories, restricted workplace with a high exposure of gas and fumes. This is the gold industry. And this is the melanosis, pigmentation, blackening of the face, and prolonged sitting operation near furnace in Bengal industry. I can go on giving these examples. The huge dust exposure without any dust mask or anything, and poor sitting posture of the old people. These are the heavy manual load carrying of 60 kg load they are carrying, and prolonged squatting job. Sir, list is a long, so I don't want to increase the list. So friends, my question is, can IMF exchange this expertise and for changing the scenario of musculoskeletal disorder in SSI? Can it be? Can your expert hand improve the scenario of musculoskeletal disorders which are going to be severe in next decade? And ILO declared that this in next decade, the single disease is caused world economic loss. So think of that. Can advanced manufacturing technology improve tools, machine, workplace, and working environment of SSI? I think IMF can do. Its expertise, its brain, its Jill can improve this situation. But how? The task ahead need to identify the occupational safety, health, and ergonomics problem for solution in SSI. Why are you writing here the solution? Because, friends, so long what we have sent the article and information on occupational safety, health, and ergonomics in India is meant for either the master's thesis project or PhD thesis project or for publication of a paper or for presenting in such conference or some government aided projects or any other aided projects. No solution and no follow-up. Whether there is a solution, but no follow-up. Nobody has returned to that place again after publication of the paper. So IMF must do something other than this system. Second, a multi-dimensional manufacturing strategy need to be formulated. Multi-dimensional strategy. The core committee of this IMF must formulate a multi-dimensional manufacturing strategy. And then you must develop a safety, health, and ergonomics committee for executing this strategy and developing a generalized training module for SSI. That can be done. And the finally, the publication of the leaflet for mass distribution in different language can be done. And the last one, the mass awareness program with active involvement of school students. That school students may be your very good hand to propagate the message of IMF. Sir, we need this type of low cost ergonomics, no cost ergonomics solution. This is a vendor without any tool. His spine load is near about 11. And if you sit in the stool, then his spine load will bring down to 6. So mathematically, if the technologies can prove that only small stool can improve the spine strength, can we not disseminate this knowledge to the poor people of small skill? So friends, yes, the advanced low-cost ergonomic concept of IMF can change the scenario. Thank you, friends.